Hey everybody, it's Blizzard. I'm playing Small. It turns out I was Wind Waker randomizer and I'm not doing well in this randomizer right now, so I've decided that I'm gonna go through at least a part, a little bit of this place of death, which is called the Savage Labyrinth. So hopefully I can get through as much of it as possible without a sword, without bombs, and yeah. It's going to be quite difficult, but I'm hopefully going to get rupees from this and maybe something in the 30 chest if I can actually make it that far. That's the real thing, is I don't know if I can make it even that far. But anyway, none of the enemies here drop anything, and the only places that drop rupees are in the checkpoint areas that aren't actually checkpoints. But anyway. So far, the boomerang's quite useful. Oi. Take that. And if I come down here again, I'm probably not gonna record it. I'm probably just gonna do it off screen. Possibly until I get to the point where I've got to already. Well, going to be getting to already. I think that's all of them. Let's keep going down. Okay. The only way to get stuff from things in this dungeon, I guess, would be to use the grappling hook. Maybe. Anyway, let's keep going deeper. I'm pretty sure you get rupee floors every 10 floors. So that's something I need to know. Ow. Okay, I got rid of one. I like combat dungeons. I just wish I actually had a good weapon to attack with. That works. Okay then. Just slowly chop it down. Like a tree. Also, I can only hold 1,000 rupees. So that's probably going to be a problem at some point. Oh dear. This is a combination. Okay, that's all of them. Let's keep going deeper. It's nice using weapons that are infinite. Like the boomerang and the hammer. Everything? Yes, it is. Okay, let's go deeper. I'm not going to keep counting the floors I'm going down. I'm just going to keep going down and fighting everything as I go. Ow. I'm going to have to switch between my weapons, unfortunately. Okay, there we go. Let's go deeper. Okay. I might also, just for now, just go like this. Okay. Oh, hello. Ow. Ow, I'm over here now. I wonder if I can glitch you into the exit. That'd be interesting. Ow. Okay. This is the first of many rupee floors where I get hearts. The main reason I came here is this is the only place where, like, pots will give, like, red and purple rupees a lot more. Okay. Let's keep going down. That didn't give me a lot of rupees. It's quite sad, but maybe I'll get something good in the middle chest. Oh, this is a good room. I know what to do about this room. I like that room. It is a nice room. It is one that I can take down quite quickly. There are a few faster beat rooms. But not a lot. Just gonna stand in front of this fire for a bit. Not actually walk into it accidentally. Oh dear. Okay. I'm sorry if I'm not talking much, I'm just concentrating on beating everything as quickly as possible. Ow. I wonder if you get more money the further down you go. That's something that I don't know. I'm pretty sure it's just the same every time, but they could give you more every rupee floor. If it wanted to. If it wanted to be nice to you. But the game could also give you a sword from the very beginning of the game, if it was being nice to you. So... and not expect you to fight Darknuts without a sword. If it was being nice to you. But anyway. Let's keep going deeper. Should probably actually use my... hammer. And also do this. It's gonna break everything in sight. Okay. Where are you? There you are. And hello you, I just hit you with the back throw attack of my hammer, I guess. That's the best thing about the hammer, is when you do a strike, it hits behind itself as well. Getting a bit of lag here, I think. Let's keep going. Is this another rupee floor? I think it might be. No, not quite. Oh, perfect. Just hitting both of them at the exact same time. And now it's the Rippy floor. It'd be nice if it just dropped silver rupees. Man, I remember that time going through the forest temple and getting 200 rupees everywhere. That would have been nice about now, to have all that money. Oh well. And also, I'm at the beginning of the end. Ow. So nice being at a one-shot enemy sometimes. Oh no. Let me just go simple. Work smarter, not harder. Here we go. Before I get my, boomerang back out, since it's so useful. Okay, let's go. Super Mario in real life. Something seems suspicious here. Let me actually just break them all out to make things easier. Make it be like that one boss from Twilight Princess. In the sky. The dragon. Whoa, it's dark in here. Can I kill you with this? No, I cannot. I'm gonna need my bow. Probably, if I can get it. Okay. There we go. All the bubbles are gone. All the bublés. Now where am I? Okay, interesting, interesting. Oh, Darknut. Oh, I'm just dead already. Except I might not be. I might be just so lucky enough to be able to use this. Ow, that didn't work. So can I not dodge his attacks like that? Or not? Maybe. That did work. Please pick it up. No. No, okay then. That's everything I can do in here, apparently. Oh, well that didn't work the way I would hoped. Oh well. So I guess I'm back to square one. I can't do that now. Cool. So there must be something I can do right now with Beetle or Tingle. One of them has something for me, and I don't know who. I did get buy enough things, though, to have the mailbox dance at some point. But I don't know when it's gonna dance, and it's difficult to make it dance. Let me just break into this real quick and get some more rupees. The Savage Labyrinth didn't even give me that many rupees. I'm still many rupees away from what I need to even complete some stuff. It's not really any good grinding spots except for rings? Light rings. And there's not many of those I actually know about. Except for maybe near the reefs. Those usually have good spots near them. Okay, buttons, who's got the buttons? Well, we can decipher one chart with Tingle. So maybe that one will lead me to where I need to be and not give me something I can't do. And don't one of you have something for me, or is that just later? 50 rupee. What about you, sir? Okay. Yep, decipher a chart. Tingle, tingle, kulo, limpa. Become readable. Okay. Let's check what that is for us. Where is... Oh, it's right there. Rock Spire. I can do that. That's actually a pretty good one to have got with my current position. So I guess for now, let me not focus on any of them, maybe? No, I guess I'm just gonna jump down normally then. Okay. Let's go... Which way? This way. Need to also get out my grappling hook for this. Might need to look up a video on how to fight dark nuts without a sword. Because it just doesn't seem possible to me. I can't figure it out. Meanwhile, shark attack. Okay, where is it? There it is. Go, 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 go. And please be what I need. Please be what I need, or at least like a million rupees so I can actually buy more things so I can go places. A golden feather. All that for a golden feather. Alright then, let's go places. I think I'm gonna head to a reef then. There's also a possible chance that I can get some of the sunken treasures without doing things, I guess. So maybe I can do that. Anyway. It's really not a whole lot I can do. I guess I haven't tried Shark Island yet. I guess I could try that now. I'm certain that Stone Watcher Island, whatever it is. I'm pretty sure I can't do that because there was dark nuts there. I think there are going to be dark nuts in the enemy hell. So I don't know why I'm trying. Which way? This way. Right? Yeah, this way. Have to open up all the switches. Although, what are the switches again? I forgot. Because there's one with the boomerang, one with the thing and the thing. What's the last one? I'm not sure. Also Octorox, apparently. Okay, what have we got here? Okay, just a switch you need to stand on. That makes things simple enough. I can't remember which order you're meant to do this in. Pretty sure it's something like that. And then just gonna do that. And just keep going. Uh-oh. I think I may have messed it up by falling in the sea. Hate it when that happens. Oh, it worked. Cool. First try. So I guess I'll do this before the end of the video to actually know if I'm actually meant to do this, because I just don't know. And if I can't do it, then it doesn't matter anyway, so. Okay. Hello, friends. Goodbye, friends. Ooh, hello, Rupee. Oh, there's a duck nut. Cool. Can they actually, like, open each other's things up, I guess, maybe? That's really not working. And that's not working either. But wait, his health is down. Wait! Did I damage him? Or is his health just bugged? What did I do? How did I hit him? Oh! Oh! Get him! Get him! Oh yes, get him! Please! Get him! Okay, he's done. Okay, so I can fight them with mad, crazy, buggy stuff. This is Crazy Madness, the video game. I want to make a game called Crazy Madness now. Oh, there's a thing there. Ow. Got him. Ow, fairy, save me. Might also need to use this as well. Oh, this is a mad mess. Oh my goodness. Ow. Oh, hearts. Hearts as well, and there's another duck nut. Oh, run. Why can I get pushed around by everything and not get what I need? Oh my goodness. So he can take damage on his armor, it just takes forever with things that aren't the sword. I need that knight's crest. Okay, just keep going. This is a mess. A huge, huge mess. Ow. Come on. Oh, come on. Okay, that one's done. I think this is the last one. Oh, I got him. How come this wasn't working last time? I don't know. Anyway. Oh my goodness. How is that working? Just slam everything with the hammer and it just works somehow. Ow. So I guess that's how you do swordless. And swordless is a horrible nightmare that I never want to experience. I guess it's not the last one, right? Anyway. Oh, come on. Oh my goodness, it's so hard to spin with the hammer. Oh, more enemies. Oh, madness, why do you not end? Oh. That works. Uh-oh, more dark nuts. Okay, just slam my hammer into them repeatedly. This is madness. How could anyone ever do this without a sword? The full game. This is basically swordless so far. If I get the sword in last place, then it's 100 basically completely swordless. Except I don't know how to fight Ganon swordless. Okay. I needed to do that, and now I have double damage, except it's not gonna matter because I need to get into their armor. Okay, I got one of them to remove his armor. And now the other ones are gonna hurt him, hopefully. Oh, they're so close to being finished off. Please, game. Okay, got that one. Come on, I am so close. The last 10 minutes of this video have been absolutely chaotic. I need him to swing at me to actually get his armor. Come on. Okay, I'm gonna just take out these guys, I guess. Come on. I might need to use my rest of my soup. Okay, just break something. Hopefully get some hearts. Okay, there we go. One more to go. Okay, there we go. There we go. There we go. He's gone. He's gone. He's gone. Get him. Get him. Get him. Get him. Yes! Oh my goodness. That was crazy. Now, was that actually worth it? Is the real question. And before I can answer that, I'm going to collect all of this extra stuff and maybe even end the video before then. Although I think I'm just gonna get it before the video ends and make it just a long video. Oh my goodness. My heart is just crazily beating at me right now because of how insane that was. Oh, I need that nice crest. Okay. How? Why would somebody want... How would someone willingly do swordless? Earth Temple Small Key. Will this be the key that I need to progress? I guess you'll have to find out next time. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys then.